Welcome to Gadgetomics. This time we will review the affordable smartwatch ET310. The main selling points of this smartwatch are not only its price, but also it has electrocardiogram or ECG feature, which we will discuss in this video. But before that, let's do the unboxing. This watch can operate normally even when not connected to a smartphone. However, for the initial time and date setup, we need to pair it with a phone using the healthware application. The smartwatch can be connected to Android and iPhone smartphones. The upper part of the body is made of metal alloy, while the lower part is made of plastic. There are heart rate sensors and what appears to be an ECG sensor. The design is a classic round shape with some ports like lugs that have sharp angles. In terms of build quality, it's actually quite good, but if it had a matte color, I think it will look better, at least for my taste. This watch has a bezel with a diameter of 46mm. With the sensor, it has a width of 48mm. The lug-to-lug distance is 53.5mm, making it a medium-sized watch. The strap uses a standard size of 22mm, so if the strap is damaged, we can easily find a replacement. Here is how it looks when I wear it. The display size is 1.39 inches. It doesn't use an AMOLED screen, so we won't get deep black colors, which is understandable given its price. However, the screen is still quite good with a resolution of 360 by 360 pixels, resulting in a smooth and non-pixelated appearance. There are 5 pre-installed watch faces on this smartwatch. Out of the 5, one can be changed. To change it, you can use the healthware application. At the time of making this video, there are 35 watch faces to choose from. To turn on the screen, you can press the button on top or the bottom, or activate the Raise to Wake feature. The sensitivity of the Raise to Wake function is good. Outdoors, as long as you are not under direct sunlight, the screen remains visible at maximum brightness settings. There is no auto brightness feature yet. Even though it doesn't use an AMOLED screen, this watch has a keep screen on feature that displays a simple watch face like this. However, if this feature is turned on, the battery will be significantly drained, lasting only 5 to 8 hours compared to the normal battery life, which can last up to a week. The top right button is used to access the menu and return to the home page. The bottom right button serves as a shortcut to the sports menu. Swiping down will take you to quick settings and show the Bluetooth connection status. There are several menu styles to choose from. In terms of screen responsiveness, it is sufficient. It may not be as smooth as more expensive smartwatches, but overall it can still be used effectively without any issue. Swiping left will access the widgets that can be selected, which widgets or features to display. Swiping right will display the recently opened menu. Swiping up will show notifications. To manage which apps can send notifications, you can use the healthware application. You cannot see the entire content of a message, only the notifications. Whenever you receive a notification, the watch will vibrate. The vibration intensity can be adjusted. It is strong enough to notice. This watch supports Bluetooth call, and here is the microphone quality of the watch.
Microphone test, test 1, 2, 3, test 1, 2, 3. Microphone test, test 1, 2, 3, test 1, 2, 3.
The watch also supports music control. Click this link if you want to control media apps on your phone. The media sound will be forwarded to the watch, and here is the speaker quality of ET310 smartwatch. Now let's talk about the interesting feature of this smartwatch, which is the ECG or electrocardiogram feature. To use this feature, we need to touch this side where the ECG image is, because this is where the electrodes are positioned. This feature won't work if we don't touch the right side of the watch. I don't know how accurate this ECG feature is, but in my opinion, it seems to work as it should be. Because if we remove our finger, the feature stops. Additionally, if we lift the watch so that the sensor on the bottom is not in contact with the skin, fluctuation will be visible in the ECG graph. To view the ECG measurement results, we need to synchronize using the healthware application. We can play back the recent ECG measurement. We can see the diagnosis indicating whether the data generated is normal or if there is potential for a heart rate condition. However, of course, this is only for reference and cannot be considered as medical data. We can also initiate ECG measurements from the healthware application. Moving on to the sports feature. There are several types of sports to choose from as seen in the video. Although some sports types display the same data, which is time, heart rate, and calories. Regarding the accuracy of the step sensor, from a manual count of 1000 steps, the watch showed 1011 steps. So the accuracy is still considered good, almost 99% accuracy. Meanwhile, the accuracy of the heart rate sensor is also good, as it has been compared with a heart rate belt, showing similar heart rate results. If it shows an error like this, make sure the heart rate warning setting is above 100. This watch doesn't have GPS, but if we start a workout from the healthware app, we can use the phone's GPS to record the workout route, while heart rate and step data are taken from the watch. If we start the workout from the phone, we can see the recent workout history in the healthware app. However, if we start a workout from the watch, we can only see the workout histories on the watch too. The watch is rated IP67, it's okay if it's briefly submerged in water, but it is not recommended for swimming. For other health features, there is a sleep monitor that detects the amount of light sleep, deep sleep, REM, and wake up time. It doesn't detect nap times. There is also a blood oxygen feature. As for other health features such as blood sugar, blood pressure, uric acid, and blood fat, they are for reference only and cannot be used as a medical measurement data. Even the temperature feature is not accurate. For the remote camera feature, it only works when you open the healthware app, meaning you cannot use the phone's built-in camera app. It only supports shake to capture. The battery life of this watch is quite decent. It can last a week if not used for sports or only for receiving notifications and checking the time. If used for sports, it can last around 5 days. The charging time is approximately 2 hours. Here are the other features of the ET310 smartwatch as seen in the video along with conclusion. As mentioned at the beginning of the video, the main selling point of this smartwatch is its ECG feature. Something that may not be present in a smartwatch priced 3 or even 4 times higher than this one. Although, once again, I cannot confirm how accurate the ECG feature is, but at least it seems to work as intended. The drawbacks of this smartwatch for me are the limited number of watch faces and the sports feature that are complementary only. However, considering its price, this can still be acceptable, especially since the watch also supports Bluetooth calls. If anyone is interested in the ET310 smartwatch, you can check the video description for the purchase link. I hope this video is helpful for someone and see you in the next video.